Chapter 3, The New Day. The next morning, Dragon awoke with the sun. "Good morning, Apple," said Dragon. The apple did not answer. So Dragon went out to the kitchen and made breakfast. When he was finished eating, he tried to wake the apple up again. "Good morning, Apple," he cried. The apple still did not answer. So Dragon went outside for a walk along the river bank. When he came back, he tried to wake the apple up again. "Good morning, Apple," he screamed. The apple still did not answer. Dragon was very worried. He called the doctor. "My apple won't talk to me," said Dragon. "Maybe it's a crab apple," said the doctor. "No," said Dragon. "I think it is sick." So Dragon took the apple to the doctor's office. They sat down next to a big walrus. "What's the matter with you?" asked the walrus. "It's my apple," said Dragon. "It won't talk to me." The walrus stared at the apple and drooled. Dragon needed a drink of water. "Will you watch my apple for me?" Dragon asked the walrus. "Sure," said the walrus, licking her lips. When Dragon came back, the apple had changed. It was not round anymore. It was not shiny anymore. It was not red anymore. Now it was wet and skinny and white. "What happened to you?" cried Dragon. "Are you all right?" The little white thing did not answer. Dragon wrapped his friend in a piece of paper and carried it home. "Don't worry," said Dragon. "Everything will be okay." When Dragon got home, the little white thing had turned all mushy and brown. "Are you hurt?" asked Dragon. The mushy brown thing did not answer. "Are you sick?" asked Dragon. But there was no answer. "Are you dead?" asked Dragon. Still, there was no answer. Dragon scratched his big head and started to cry.